Freaking.com. When I first was preparing to move to New Hampshire in late 2003, I actually wound up moving in 2004, but before I even got there, there was someone who welcomed me, and her name is Jane Aiken. She lived in Bedford, and she was on our forums on the Free State Project back in the day, and it was nice to have someone local who was so active in supporting us. She was a radio host at the time as well. Well, she was elderly at the time, and now she's really elderly, but she's still alive, and she's got a sometime column at patch.com, and I wanted to read you her latest one. Quote, "Who's designing your master plan? Unelected and unaccountable groups want to redesign New Hampshire's towns, and no, it's not a theory, it's a fact." By Jane Aiken, Patch contributor, July 11th, 2018. This post was contributed by a community member. Who's designing your master plan? Perhaps you read an article in the Union Leader online health section entitled, "Two NH Towns Received Coveted Distinction from AARP" by Travis R. Morin, published on July 01, 2018. Readers can easily research Travis R. Morin and discover that he is not an actual UL reporter, but an employee of AARP. He was apparently given a free pass to put a happy spin on what should be a worrisome intrusion in local control. Readers should be aware that there is no coveted distinction being sought by towns. Certainly there should never be a desire to capitulate to outside non-governmental private groups that enjoyed zero accountability from the taxpaying public. Such groups hope to influence your town's master plan with improvements that are nothing but social engineering aimed at leveling the playing field. The program described in the article is the same described in the Union Leader LTE of 7/11/2018 regarding the reason for the Bedford surveys. The program, which was the result of the World Health Organization having approached our town council, claims to want to make Bedford more habitable, as if it's not already, with intentional design for various age groups and economically more sustainable. There is nothing more sustainable about higher taxes. Intentional design sounds great, but by whose intentions? Is it assumed that millennials will always want to live in a city? Is anyone considering the fact that we older people used to be in their age group but eventually wanted a home on an acre of land away from the trains and riffraff of the big cities? Why would anyone who worked hard to be able to afford to live in Bedford suddenly want to urbanize it? This push to urbanize is happening all over the country, but it doesn't have to happen here if people do something about it. Wake up, New Hampshire, or you will no longer be living free. If Bedford or Goffstown residents have any questions, feel free to call me after 9 a.m. and before 8 p.m., please, at 472-7488, unquote. So, by way of background, Jane is really upset that the authorities are going to be allowing possibly some apartments to be built at a busy intersection in Bedford, actually one of the busiest intersections in the whole state, I believe. Personally, I tend to think, you know, anyone who wants to build an apartment complex should pretty much be able to. There shouldn't be a need to request government permission. But the problem is here that there will be, I guess, the claim is that there will be subsidized apartments. So there would be a taxpayer expense involved. And it really does remind me, you know, the surveys that she's talking about are obviously, it's a government survey that was spewed out to Bedford residents, and there was a bunch of leading questions leading in that direction, the idea of urbanizing Bedford. And it reminds me of what happened, you know, like a very mild, very relatively benign version of what happened in the Soviet Union in the 1920s, where you had this, okay, you know, the Soviet Union was not an industrial place, so they pretended it was, and they forced it to be industrial. They forced it to urbanize when previously it had been agrarian. They felt, you know, that they needed, you know, that would improve their power base, because they, you know, as a workers' party that was running the Soviet Union, but they didn't have factory workers, so they just created these artificial factory workers. To me, it smacks of that, without all the killing. And it gives credence to these people who otherwise would just be written off as conspiracy theorists who hate the United Nations. Well, maybe they are conspiracists. Maybe they do hate the United Nations. Maybe they are seeing ghosts in some places. But I saw that survey, and it was real. And to me, it seemed to verify the concerns those people have.
What are you arresting this man for?
You've seen the dramatic liberty arrests in Keene, New Hampshire. Now see 111 reasons why you should move there and reinforce these gutsy activists. Keene's advantages are compelling, and the list of reasons to move has just been updated. For details, visit freekeene.com.